Here's the mic.
Nope, son of a bitch. Saludos. I don't think so. If it's just us. Yes, ma'am. I don't think so. What's that, babe? We got a few minutes. Is that you? Oh. Spooking me. Guys, a couple more minutes and we'll get started. Ben, Christina, good to see you. Christina, you look very contemplative in your picture that's on there. Well done. Guys, not going to need much today. If you have like a band, that'd be great. If you have an ab mat, PVC stick, and a jump rope, that's all we're really looking for. If you have that, it'll be good. Huh? Oh, yeah. All right. Yeah, Jen, what's up? Good to see you. All right, guys, we'll get started. Let me pull up. So we always Instagram live our whiteboard talks. We got Betty too. Sweet. So once Shannon gets back here and oh yeah, everyone's signing on right at 10. Just those last minute sign-ons. Hey Shannon, time to go. Will you Instagram? All right, guys, so let's get started here. Like I said, you're really only gonna need a band, a PVC, an ab mat if you have it, but not really necessary. You can use a t-shirt or whatever. And then a jump rope for double unders. If you don't have that either, it doesn't really matter. We'll figure it all out. Okay. So plan for today. Let's get into it. The warm-up. This is an old school CrossFit warm-up. Actually, this is like the one I used to do when we first started CrossFit. It was like the suggested CrossFit warm-up that CrossFit actually put out like 11, 12 years ago. So we're gonna go through this two times. It's gonna be a Samson stretch. You're gonna lunge out, reach up high. You can go side to side if you want to, 15 times. Then 15 PVC overhead squats, 15 ab mat sit-ups, 15 hip extensions and or good mornings. Just try to get that posterior chain warmed up, really getting the heels. 15 pull-ups of any variation. This can be pull-ups, ring rows, jumping pull-ups, anything you can really just kind of, if you have dumbbells and that's all you have, like 15 rows, all we're really looking for is get that back warmed up, and then 15 dips and any variation, couch dips, ring dips, box dips, whatever you have, chair dips. We're just gonna do 15 of each twice, okay? For our seated athletes out there, we're gonna do an overhead reach, PVC pass-throughs, Russian twists, good mornings, and then same thing, pull-ups and dips of any variation. Once we get through the warm-up, we're gonna get into the focus. This is a nice little, glutes, hammies, and hips, oh my, is what I kind of call it. It's gonna be a 12-minute EMOM, basically three rounds of this. You're gonna do 15 hip bridges. If you have a hip circle or a band, awesome. If not, no worries. You're gonna do 15 monster walks, same thing. If you have a hip circle or a band, awesome. If not, no worries. We'll just demonstrate all of these. You're gonna do 15 hip rockers, which is kind of laying on the ground. I also call them cheerleader sits, any way you wanna call them. And then we're gonna do single unders. Now, here's the fun part about the single unders and the focus. We're gonna learn how to modulate our speed with the jump rope, because if you can control your jump rope speed, you'll be much better at double unders in the long run. So the first round, I want you to try to jump really slow while still only getting a single jump. The second round, you want to go a little bit faster. In the third round, I want you to try to do single unders as fast as you can, okay? So that's what we're looking for there. For our seated athletes, it's gonna be 15 bandy rows, 15 bandy wall walk, so band around your wrist, five this way, five this way, five up, five down. 15 teacups with a really light weight or just the weight of your arm, and then a minute of unilateral skier or 30-30 bandy pull downs, where you just kind of 30 seconds right arm, 30 seconds left arm, pulling it down. Once we get done with the focus, we'll go over the movements for the workout. This is a nice little workout. Most people should be able to do this all together. Pretty cool. It's four time, and I know we kind of listed it as a 10-minute time cap. I'm going to give you guys 15 minutes, just seeing some of the times from this morning. It's going to be 50, 40, 30, 20, 10. If you have a weight vest, great. If not, again, no worries. It'll be just as hard otherwise. So 50 double unders, 50 mountain climbers, 50 step-ups. That's 50 total, so 25 per leg. 40, 40, 40, 30, 30, 30, 20, 20, 20, 10, 10, 10. Okay? If you don't have a jump rope, we're going to do lateral hops. So just very quick back and forth lateral hops. So that'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 until you hit 50. And then step-ups, if you want to add weight to your step-ups instead of a weight vest, hold like 20 pounds or 14 pounds, whatever you really got. Don't go over 20 pounds for the step-ups. We want you guys to still stay moving with them. Not too bad. If you don't have anything to step up onto, you're just going to do high knees holding a weight to your chest for the same amount of reps. So every single time a knee comes up, that's one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 50 high knees, 40 high knees, 30, so on and so forth. For our seated athletes, this is a version for inside your chair or in your chair. 50 U-turns, 50 shoulder to shoulder with a med ball. And then we're going to cut the reps in half from med ball over shoulder. So 25 med ball over shoulder, 20, 15, 10, 5. We're going to knock that out once we get through the workout and you guys crush it. We're going to do a quick 6-minute EMOM finisher. Tilt the screen down. There we go. 6-minute EMOM finisher. You're going to do 12 Romanian split squats on your right leg the first minute, 12 on your left leg the second. We're going to go back and forth. So you get 3 reps of 12 per leg. All you need is about a 4 to 6 inch plate to put your foot up on. So one foot is on a 4 to 6 inch plate behind you, basically in a lunge position. If you have anything to hang on to, you're going to hang on to them on the sides. And you're going to do 12 reps just up and down really quickly, rest the rest of the minute, switch legs in the next minute. For our seated guys, same thing pretty much. It's going to be alternating each arm. It's going to be dumbbell rows. Sorry, I switched up this morning. So you're going to lean forward 12 rows on this side of the first arm, 12 rows on this side the second arm, second minute, and you're going to go back and forth until you get 3 reps of 12 per arm. All right. Any questions, comments, concerns on the plan for the day or what's about to happen? If you have them and you're muted, go ahead and type them into the chat. If you don't have them and we're good to go, I'm gonna set the computer back down over here. Shannon's gonna hop out in front of the camera by Instagram. And I'm gonna have her set up in front and we're gonna go through this first round of this warm up together. Good question. The Samson stretch is basically a lunge with a reach up overhead. I'm going to have her demo all these movements real quickly, and then we're going to do them all together. So a Samson stretch is you basically step out, reach up as high as you can, grab your hands. You can lean left to right if you want to, but that's a Samson stretch. And you're going to do 15 of those back in 15 total. So like 8 on one leg, 7 on the other. It's 2 rounds, so you can even it out. The next one's going to be a PVC overhead squat. So PVC overhead, make sure you have a good position. And you're just gonna squat 15 times. The next movement's gonna be an ab mat sit-up. If you don't have an ab mat, no worries. You can just do sit-ups. Or if you really want that ab mat in there, go ahead and take a hoodie or a t-shirt and bundle it up and put it under your low back. It does the same thing. Then you're gonna do a good morning or hip extensions. If you have a GHD, your house is awesome. Well done. If not, it's just gonna be a good morning. Looks like this. Really focusing on pushing the weight back into the heels, keeping the back flat, only going down as far as you can with your back flat, okay? Then 15 pull-ups of any variation, ring rows, table rows. I saw someone doing rows in the back of their truck bed. You can do dumbbell rows, whatever you want. She'll probably end up hitting the ring rows because we have access to them. So just making sure we're getting some pulling in. And then finally, we'll finish out with some dips. So box dips, ring dips, whatever you have. She's going to do some box dips here. Just try to get the shoulder below the elbow and then back up. All right, we're going to do 15 of each of those 2 times through. So let's go ahead and we're going to start with the Samson stretch. So go ahead and step yourself back. You're just going to step forward and then reach up as high as you can 15 times. Go ahead and start. When you get down there, really reach to the ceiling with the heel of your palm. If you flip your hands out and press out with it, it's a nice stretch there. 15 reps. Maybe I hope that answers what a Samson stretch is. This is super old school stuff. It's pretty fun. Brings me back to the day when I was doing CrossFit out of my garage, or like had my Ford Taurus loaded down with barbells and weights and kettlebells and dumbbells, and I would drive to parks and do like Fran while people were doing drug deals next to me. It was awesome. True roots of CrossFit right there. Once you guys finish those 15 Samson stretch, go ahead and grab your PVC. Snap it up overhead and give me 15 quality overhead squats. And I want quality, so don't just try to move through it to get them done. Really focus on how you're moving, pressing up as hard as you can, armpits forward, tight at the bottom. We're really focused on moving well here throughout this warm-up. 15 lace squats. Once you get to those 15 overhead squats, we're gonna go into 15 ab mat sit-ups or 15 sit-ups. But don't feel the need to rush. Go ahead and take your time on this. This is your warm-up. We're trying to get moving today. It's noon, I think, where most of you guys are at, because I think most of you guys on here are East Coasters or Canadians. We're 2 hours behind you guys, so it's only 10:10 here. Fifteen quick ag mat sit-ups. Once you finish those 15 ab mat sit-ups, go ahead and hit me with 15 hip extensions and or good mornings. And guys, this is a warm-up, so I know I said 15 reps of each, but if you get to like 10 reps and you're like, man, that's good, it is a warm-up. So remember, we're just trying to get things moving and grooving, so don't kill yourself on this. Try to get all 15, but if that's just not in the cards today, it's just not in the cards today. It is Friday, I think. It's quarantine, so technically today is Blur's Day, as all the days have blurred together at this point. Once you finish those good morning guys, just give me 15 variations of any kind of row, pull-up, or that or the like, and 15 dips. 15 pull-ups, 15 dips. Again, this is the one where if you get to like 5 or 10, you're like, man, that feels good for today. Just go with how you feel. Jen, if you have anything to do like dumbbell rows or like bent over rows, I'd rather see that than anything else. If you just don't have pull-ups, then just or anything, or do pull-ups or rows, do some like dumbbell rows or odd object rows. Really get that back singing before we get into this workout. And if you have nothing to do dips on, go ahead and get 15 push-ups. There's nowhere to do dips if you don't have a bench. If you literally have nothing, go ahead and hit us with some push-ups. I'd probably knock those reps down to like 10 at that point. And then once you finish those dips, go ahead and go into that second round. Whenever you're ready, second round is completely on you, right in the Samson stretches. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns while warming up, go ahead and hit it in the chat. My quads are on fire. Slow down, cut the reps. Shannon's question was, my quads are on fire, because she rocked the workout yesterday too. And as she told me, it was a little bit of arms and a lot of bit of quads. If your legs are just on fire and the Samson stretch or the overhead squats are killing you, cut the reps, man. Again, warm up. Let's feel good after this warm up. Mm-hmm. Once you finish the overhead squats, guys, let's go into ab mat sit-ups. Remember, it's Samson stretch, overhead squats, and then ab mat sit-ups. Then we got some hip extensions and good mornings. And then we're gonna finish that last round of pull-ups and dips. Good morning, it's beautiful, guys. And then just finish off them pull-ups and them dips. On those pull-ups and dips, let's just really focus on staying active in that shoulder. The whole point of the pull-ups and dips is to get that shoulder nice and active. I know there's not a ton of pulling or pressing in today's workout, but you'd be surprised how much you actually use your shoulders and set your shoulders on those mountain climbers and step-ups. When we finish them dips, guys, go ahead and take a breather, relax, get some water, breathe a bit. You should feel pretty warm. No surprise, a warm-up from Coach Glasson himself is a little rough. So grab what you need, water, bathroom breaks, wrist wraps, elbow sleeves, knee sleeves, headbands, prayer beads, pictures of Matt Fraser or Rich Froning. Tia Claire Toomey. I'm a Kara Saunders fan myself. Kara Saunders. They say things weird in Australia. All right. Looks like pretty much everyone is done with this. So guys, here's what I need you to do. If you have a band, like a hip circle or a small band, please go ahead and grab that. If you don't, it's not a big deal. We'll show you guys how to do this without. It's just that band adds a little extra to this focus that gets things nice and warmed up. Okay. Shannon is grabbing a hip circle now. She knocked these out. So what's going to happen is the first minute, you're going to be 15 hip bridges. They're in there, or you're going to use a small band. The second minute, you're going to do monster walks. The third minute, you're going to do hip rockers, which we'll show. And then the final minute, we'll do some jumpy single unders. Okay, so let's have Shannon show you what this looks like. So the hip bridges are on the ground. If you have a hip circle, put it above your knee. If you have a really small band, we'll put it above the knee for this and then above the ankles for the monster walks. She's gonna lay down on her shoulders, hands at her side, and she's gonna push the ground away with her heels and bring her hips up to the ceiling and really drive out into that band. Boondock, come here, bud. Our humans are our support animal. Boone is here to help. So that's hip bridges. Monster walk, she's gonna hop to her feet. She's gonna get into a quarter squat, really drive out into that band, and she's gonna take 5 steps left, 5 steps right, 5 steps forward, 5 steps back. Really trying to keep that tension in the band. Notice when she walks forward, it's feet together and back, feet together and back. It's beautiful. Then she's gonna do hip rockers. So band comes off on that third minute. She's on a hip rocker. She's gonna sit down like she's a cheerleader. And if there we go. And without using her hand, she's gonna go from this way to the other way, back and forth. This is the quote unquote RX version of this. If you need to put your hands down for a little stability, go ahead. We're just trying to get those hips opened up on this. And then final one is single unders. We'll go with how you feel on that, okay? Any questions on the focus? So minute one is 15 reps of hip ridges. Minute two is 5 steps in each direction for monster walks. Minute three is 10 total hip rockers. And minute four is single unders for that whole minute. Questions, comments, concerns? Funny anecdotes? Nothing? You guys are a content bunch, I hope. Content. All right, so here's what's going to happen. Let's go ahead and get this party started. It's going to be 12 minutes. So go ahead and if you don't have a hip circle, do the exact same thing. Just try to really focus on staying tight in the butt. Okay. Okay. Here we go. Starting in 10 seconds. Bunda, come here. We'll start with those hip ridges in 3, 2, 1 and go. Really squeezing the butt up at the top. Give yourself a second up there. Pushing the ground away with your heels and drive it on into that band if you have one. Once you have 12, go ahead and relax. Pop to your feet. Monster walks is going to be the next minute. Yeah, sorry, 15 hip bridges. Did I say 10? I meant 15. Do what I meant, not what I said. We have 20 seconds, guys, so breathe, relax. Remember, this next one is 5 steps in each direction. Those monster walks is the quarter squat down, really drive it down into the band, or really just think about squeezing your butt. And go. Stand tight when you're doing these. Keeping the hips leveled, keeping those knees torqued out like you're trying to screw your feet into the ground. If you want a little extra challenge on the side-to-side ones, go ahead and make your feet duck-footed. So turn those toes in a little bit more. Makes it a little harder. Front to back, just keep them straight forward. Just 5 each direction, and then you're done, guys. 5 each direction, and then relax. Trust me, you guys, your butt will be on fire after all this is done. Once you're done with that, guys, and you're preparing for the next section in the next minute and 15 seconds, you're going to sit down on the ground, that nice cheerleader sit. Nice, Jen. Way to hit that cheerleader pose. Well done. I love it. And go. So 10 of these, so 5 each direction. As best you can, don't use your hands. Look, Ma, no hands, is what Shannon says. And I have to remind her, I'm not her mother. I am her husband. It's weird. Don't be weird. Once you get 10 total hip rockers, go ahead and hop up onto your feet and get ready for some jumpy, jumpy single unders. I'll turn off the music just a little bit. Dance breaks are always encouraged when you're resting. If you want to bust a move, I feel like that's a great way to get things moving and grooving and warmed up. We have 15 seconds. Guys, remember this first round of single unders is slow. So try to do single unders as slow as you can. Really trying to control and modulate the speed of your rope. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, and go. Keep those elbows tucked in. Remember, we're trying to use our wrists, not our arms, to make this rope move. Try to make that single jump. If you don't have a jump rope, we're just going to try to get them lateral jumps in. Start slow, like really slow lateral jumps. Remember, guys, this is not supposed to kill you. So if you need to take a break in this minute time frame, go for it. We're just kind of learning how to move that rope. Boondock, come here, bud. You got 20 seconds. Really keep that rope nice and slow. Jump nice and slow in those lateral jumps you need to. All right, guys, 5 seconds. We're going back into those hip bridges. 3, 2, 1, and hippie bridge. 15 of them, regardless of what I said the first round, 15 of them. Seconds into this minute, really driving the floor part away with your heels, keeping those heels down, squeeze your butt cheeks towards the ceiling. When you're done, guys, go ahead and rest. Don't know if you can hear our music, but we're rocking out some Bell Biv DeVoe. Can't get any better than that. Here we go, guys. Monster walks in 3, 2, 1, and go. Man, if you want to add a challenge, duck foot your toes on this one. Pigeon toe on this, and really drive through your knee to push that band out. Should add a little extra difficulty. And then feet straight forward for the front to back. We got 20 seconds. We're going back to those hip rockers. Ten seconds, guys. Into those hip rockers. And 3, 2, 1, and go. But that is not very helpful, bud. This is our dog Boone. Oh, and he's gone. And we're gonna rest, guys. We're 30 seconds in. This is a single unders. We're gonna speed the rope up a little bit. Let's try to go a little bit faster for those of you guys doing lateral jumps. Again, try to stay a little bit lower to the ground and try to jump a little bit faster back and forth. We're really trying to keep that speed or get that speed up there a little bit. We've got 15 seconds. What a perfect song for this minute. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, and go. A little faster with that jump rope. Remember, elbows staying tight, using those wrists. Shannon's doing a wonderful job, good positioning for this jump rope. Her shirt just says, do better, from our friends at Equip Product, just do better, which is a quote from Stouty and myself. We got 20 seconds. We're going back to those hip bridges. Last round of this stuff, guys. What's that? Yep. Go ahead and go, guys, on those hip bridges. She said those slow jump ropes were the worst, and that's true, guys. But if you can learn to modulate your jumping, the speed of your rope, to wherever you want to, I swear to you, double unders and even triple unders become exponentially easier. So learning how to really control your jump rope is really important. 15 hip bridges, and then we're gonna go back to those monster walks in 15 seconds. Last round of this stuff, guys. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Excuse me. Again, really driving out through those knees on these. Don't want your knees cave in at all if you're using a band. Especially don't let them cave in if you're not using the band. No excuse for that. Finish these and then back on your butt. You're done with the band around the knees. We're going to those hip rockers. Your quads are too mighty. That band's not coming off on its own. In case you didn't hear her, she says she has thighs as big as her dreams. 10 seconds, guys. 5 seconds, last round of hip rockers in 3, 2, 1, and go. This could also be a pretty sick dance move if you wanted it to be, I guess, these hip rockers. You look pretty cool doing them, everyone. There it is, babe. Nice work. Well done, guys. All we have left is some jumpy. This last minute, I want you to try to get those single unders as fast as you can. As fast as you can. Be careful, don't whip yourself in the bed. If you're doing lateral jumps, try to jump back and forth as fast as possible. Really going for speed on this. Ten seconds. And 5, 3, 2, 1, and go. No double unders, just fast singles. Learn your rope, feel it. Remember, in order to be fast, you have to be smooth and you have to have rhythm. So if you're a bad dancer, it's gonna be difficult. We got 30 seconds, guys. Remember, this is warm up, break where needed. We got 10 seconds left, guys. Three, two, one, and rest, guys. Relax. All right. How's everyone feeling? If you're feeling pretty good, go ahead and give me a thumbs up or a wave or, oh, there's another puppy, Abby. That's a nice looking pup you got there. What else we got? Christina's got her pup. Everyone just has their dog. Just a puppy party. I love it. Love puppy parties. Guys, here's the deal. We're going to get ready to go into the workout. So you need your jump rope or the place to do lateral jumps. You need a place to do mountain climbers, which we'll demonstrate here in a second and goes over some do's and don'ts. And then some place to do step ups. If you have a weight vest and you want to lock that thing on, go for it now. This is also a great time to get some water, run to the bathroom, whatever you want to do. That's on you right now. Give you a couple minutes. If you just want to breathe for a second, that's fine too. Tell your video. Okay. True story. When Shannon.
Hey, Kevin.
Yeah.
This is Jen. Should I do single unders 100?
Yeah, so we're about to go over that, but a good question. Jen's question is, what if I don't have double unders? What do I do? Well, single unders, it's going to be 100, then you're going to do 80, then you do 60, then you're going to do 40, then you're going to do 20. So double the number of double unders for single unders. If you're like, Kevin, I'm kind of getting double unders, but I'm not quite ready to do 50 of them, what I want you to do is give me two sets of double under attempts, and then finish it with single unders. So say Shannon is trying to work on double unders and she gets 10 on her first attempt and 5 on her second attempt. That leaves her with, 35 left. She's going to do 70 single unders. That's where we're going to work this. So give me two good double under attempts, finish out with single unders times two if you want to work on your double unders but don't quite have that many of them. Okay. She's choosing to strap a vest on. Good on her. Again, not necessary, but a nice little challenge. Funny story, when she moved out here from Delaware like a year and a half ago, somewhere like that. Somewhere in there. And as a welcome to Colorado present, I got her a weight vest. What a wonderful fiance boyfriend I was.
It was a dozen roses and a weight vest.
Super sweet. I'm awesome. So guys, here it is. Double unders or double unders. I'm not going to go over them. Mountain climbers. Here's what they look like. Well, here's my pet peeve with double unders. People landing on their toes. So when you land with that foot forward, I want you to try to get that toe as close to the palm of your hand as you can and land on your heel. So we're really trying to get switching back and forth here as fast as you can. Don't be that person that lands on their toes and does like half ass. Yeah, I don't care about that. That does nothing for you. That's just called twerking. Don't do it. Land with that full foot flat at front. Okay, that's what we're looking for there. On the step ups, if you guys can see over here, ooh, a little voice crack on that. Make sure that you step all the way up onto it with one leg and stand all the way up. So full foot on there, stand all the way up and all the way back down. Don't do the like, I'm tired and hunched over, but I never actually extend myself step ups. I don't want them. I don't like them. I will call you out to everyone. All right, make sure you stand all the way up with them, okay? So 50 double unders, 50 mountain climbers, 50 step ups, 30 double unders, 30 mountain climbers, 30 step ups, 20, 20, 20, 10, 10, 10. Single unders are times two, lateral hops are not. If you wanna use some kind of weight for the step ups instead of a weight vest, that's fine. And if you have nothing to step up onto, gonna hit me with some high knees while holding a weight. Any questions, comments, or concerns of what's expected of you for this workout? Everyone feeling pretty good. Like I said, we're gonna cap this at 15 minutes. I don't think it's gonna take you guys that long, but I wanna give you guys time to do it and get through everything. So that's what we're looking for. If no one has any questions, it looks like everyone's pretty good. Christina, your emotional support animal is looking like he's ready to go. So I'm assuming you are too. Good boy or girl. I don't know if it's a girl or boy. I just assumed, my apologies. All right, here we go, guys. No questions. What's that?
Are we running through, like, we'll do the double unders, single unders, and then down 50 for the next, 50 for the next, and back up, or just do whatever we want?
So you're going to do 50 double unders, and then 50 mountain climbers, and then 50 step-ups, and then 40 double unders, 40 mountain climbers, 40 step-ups, and you're going to run in that order the entire way. So you have to finish all. Thanks. What's that?
I said perfect. Thanks. That's all.
Awesome. So it's Lola, awesome. So it is a girl. My bad, Christina, but beautiful dog you got there. Looks like she's ready to work out. All right, guys, here we go. 50, 40, 30, 20, 10, double unders, mountain climbers, and step-ups. Starting in 10 seconds, I'll crank the tunes. Here we go, and 3, 2, 1, go. Get through those double unders, guys. Get into those mountain climbers. Get through that round of 50. Move quick. Christina, beautiful mountain climbers. Ready to get that foot flat, bouncing back and forth, loving it. Land with that full foot. Get that foot as close to your hands as possible. What a great support animal, Christina. She is really helping you out on those mountain climbers. She's really doing a great job. Get to those mountain climbers and get to those step-ups, guys. Stand all the way up, both feet on the box. Come on back down after you're done with those mountain climbers. You guys don't have to move fast, just move through. This big, big round of 50 is something you gotta get through. Stay moving. Come on, guys, come on, breathe. Make sure you're breathing. Find a rhythm with your breath and breathing. Deep breath in, deep breath out, and just keep it up. Guys, we're 4 minutes deep. 4 minutes deep. Let's keep it up. This round of 50 is a bear. Just get through it. Keep up that hard work, guys. Keep it moving. Breathe and move. This is called consistency on this. Beautiful job, Ben. Let's keep it up. That round of 50 is the biggest one. Let's just keep it going. Finish that round of 50. Get to those 40s. Christina, I just love Lola. She is the best. Keep it up, guys. Keep it moving. Ramos, once you get through that round of 40, things get a little bit easier. Nice, Jen. Way to get back to those mountain climbers. Let's knock them out quick. Knock them out quick. Ben, already on his round of 30, loving it. Keep breathing, guys. We're 7 minutes deep, about halfway to that time cutoff. But good news is, if you're into your round of 40, you're probably over halfway done with your reps. That's a nice surprise, huh? Breathe and move, guys. Breathe and move. On those step-ups, it's all about consistency. All about consistency. Everything speeds up once you get to that 40, guys. Come on. Big breath in, big breath out. Keep breathing into your stomach, breaths into your stomach, and stay moving in a rhythm. Consistency is key to this workout, guys. You guys are doing great. Let's keep it up. Stay moving. No slowing it down. Oh, Abby, welcome back. Breathe when you need to, and let's keep it up. Awesome, Abby. Well done. I mean, if it was difficult, it was difficult. Come on, Ben. Finish it out. I know you're right there. Once you guys get in that round of 30, it's time to kick those jets on. Right. We're almost there, guys. We're almost there. We're at 11 minutes. We got 4 minutes left. Beautiful work, guys. Come on, let's finish strong, all of us. Finish strong, all of us. Come on, get to those small numbers. Get to those 20s and 10s, guys. You got this. Breathe and move, guys. Breathe and move. Find that nice rhythm up and down. Two and a half minutes, guys. 2.5 minute warning. Let's keep it up. Get every rep you can in. Deep breaths, guys. Deep breaths. 2 minute warning. Almost there, guys. Almost there. We got about 90 seconds left. Final minute, 1 minute left, guys. Get every rep you can in. Last 45 seconds, guys. Let's get it together. Come on, finish it out. Final 30 seconds. Five, three, two, one, and time. Guys, well done. Very well done. I'm gonna give you guys a second to breathe. Give you guys a second to breathe. While you guys are breathing, I'm going to collect your scores. I'm going to get your scores on our whiteboard because, you know, that's half the fun. If you do a time cap, add a second per rep. So say you had 20 reps left, it's going to be 15, 20 for the time cap. I'm going to unmute everyone so I don't have to sit here and Abby, would you like, I know you did an extra round and everything. Figured it, any idea what your original time was? Oh, you're breaking it big time. Go ahead and type it in the comments because your connection's not very good. I can't hear you. Move on. Christina, what was your time? 14:30. Ben, any idea?
10:59.
Nice. Jen, what do you got for me?
I got the calculator. I'll report back.
Okay. Betty, what do you got for me?
Somewhere around when you said 90 seconds left.
Okay, same thing. 13:30. There we go.
All right, 15:55.
Abby, I think you joined back in right around the 10-minute mark. That's where we're gonna put you down at. Nice little 10-minute mark. All right, beautiful guys. Got a nice little whiteboard score over there for us. I don't know. This whiteboard. That way we can all sharing our times and have a good time and enjoy things. Guys, here's what we're gonna do. I want you guys to find like a 4 to 6 inch something to put your back foot on. And we're gonna do that last 6 minutes of accessory work to get some blood. The whole purpose of this thing, guys, just so you know, the whole purpose of this finisher is to pump some blood back into your legs. It's gonna feel like we're crushing them just a little bit, but I promise you by doing this finisher, they will feel better tomorrow. So those 12 split squats should be quick. If you want to do them with no weight, great. If you want to add a little weight, make sure that it's in a low hang position. Let's go ahead and grab like a 4-inch plate. That's way too high. No weight vest. So guys, if you have like a 45-pound bumper plate, those work well for this. We don't want this to be too high because we're really not trying to stretch out the hip. We're trying to get some blood into the quad. So remaining in split squat, she's gonna put her back foot on here. Her front foot needs to be out. A little bit of Fran cloth there for her. Her front foot needs to be out kind of far so she can keep that front shin vertical. And she's just gonna go down and 12 reps where she taps and stands real quick. The key here is speed. So see the speed she's going at? That's what we're looking for these, all right? Go and relax. You have a ton of these. So you're going to do 12 on one leg, and then the next minute you're going to do 12 on the next leg, and we're going to go back and forth for 6 minutes. Any questions on that? We're pretty good there. All right, let's party. Let's party with these Romanian split squats. Or Bulgarian split squats, whatever you want to call them. We're going to start in 10 seconds. And 3, 2, 1, and go. Try to keep that front shin vertical. So we're really sitting back. If you feel like your knee is pushing forward, step that front foot out a little bit farther and sit back into that back leg. Bend that back knee a little bit more, but it's going to be a quick 12. I promise you, these are techniques older than all of us here from like early 1900s where the Russians would use this in the conjugate method to pump blood back in the muscles to aid in recovery. I promise you this will make your legs feel better tomorrow. If you do these for speed, you kind of get that blood pump, that body pump into those legs. We got 20 seconds. Three, two, one, and go. Her question was, do you hold the top at the end? And the answer is no. Just pop through those 12 and just get out of it. Push the thing about driving back with that front foot, like we're trying to drive through the heel, not through the toe. That weight in the front foot should be completely in that heel. Quick 12, guys, quick 12. And then shake it out, walk it out. Yeah, our dogs are really concerned about Shannon right now. They don't know what's happening to her, but she's fine, I promise. Come here, buddy. Fifteen seconds, guys. We're going back to that first leg, round doso. If you forgot which leg, just pick one, and then do the other one the next minute. 3, 2, 1, and go. Jenna, I like that support. Try to lock that front knee out when you stand up. Think about trying to stand up all the way. Here they go. Yeah, there we are. Speed in full range. Speed in full range. Only as fast as we can go, keeping that range of motion nice and party. Guys, stand up, shake your legs out in between each round, breathe deep into your lungs. Should feel like you're going to have a little bit of a wobble after this, and you will. Your legs will work just slightly better than my own. All right, here we go. Round 4 and 3, 2, 1, and go. One more round each side, guys. One more round each side. You guys doing great, almost done. We got 15 seconds going on to round number 5. Three, two, one, and go. We got one more round after this, guys, and then it is lay finished. That is my best version of French for it's over. Flawless French, in case you're wondering. We got 20 seconds, guys. We're going to that last round. Showing you. Check them out. 5, 3, 2, 1, and go. And that is all she wrote, ladies and gentlemen, for the noon o'clock, or if you're here in Denver, the 10 o'clock class. Thank you for joining us. I'm on mute everyone for now. And if you guys have anything, the questions, comments, concerns, you guys can go ahead and hit us with them. If you guys are good to go and you're feeling well, go ahead and have a beautiful Friday in quarantine. A nice Friday night quarantini, which is vodka and emergency. So enjoy that. Other than that, guys, have a great day.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jan.
Bye.
All right, guys. See you later.